Welcome back to Let's Play Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. Blind, I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're heading towards, eventually to Rudo Castle, I think is the name. That's the wrong path. We're supposed to go this way. We're supposed to first be heading to Jerufes to talk to a swordsman who's in jail. And then eventually, yeah, heading to Rudo Castle. I'm assuming the game will end here. When we started at Ragpick Village and then went to the Shrine in Dean, and I think then to Raguna, and then sailed across to Neri and Arud. Yeah. So we're heading this way. We're fighting stuff. Fortunately, there's only two of us. But the pet's anger will help us a little bit. Boom! Fortunately, it didn't do much to that egg thing. Let's try to finish off the wild boar then, I think. Even though it's not as powerful, we'll eliminate an enemy right off, I think. After we get hit by a fireball. Points. Wow. Another fireball coming online. I hope we pick up another party member soon. On the other side, we're hogging a lot of this XP to ourselves. Chris catching up to Jurio, level 25. And has learned La Recure, which is, I think, is that a full heal? Because Philly learned that right before she left the party. And I was like, damn it. A large amount of damage. Oh, it spreads out for all allies. So hopefully do pick up some more party members, because as of right now, it would only heal two people. Wild boar and carom eggs, that's what they call. They're just moving up, and we're running past them. One down. Wow, Jurio with that sword. Just recently got that sword. Forgot what it's called. We'll get B, because it's right here. One left. An old 1-2 punch. I love seeing it. Wow. I love seeing them, the freaking levels go up so high. That's awesome. So, we got challenging, a little more challenging battles, but more XP as a result, so I can't really complain. Should we fight that last one? What's this say? Oh, it's like a tombstone or something. Desert checkpoint. East is Haruku, 10 to 1 Milos. We just left that. Alright. Let's fight this. Or these. Okay. Finishing move on the Karamege. I guess she trembles when the fireball hits her. It makes me feel bad. Looks like they vibrate. That's what you get, throwing fireballs at us. Very naughty. And finish off the boar here. Oh boy, 22 points left on her. We'll be alright. Jurio, level 26 now. Wow. Then we got some angel food. Not hungry yet, are you? Just check. Not hungry yet, okay. Well, you found something for us. Nice, a full mind potion. We might need to make use of that stuff soon. Large amount of damage for a single character. That works. Desert checkpoint. Huh. You just walk right around this fence. Hi. So we don't actually have to check in with him. We can just go around the fence. Gadona soldier says, once we get past here, we're at Gadona. I mean, once I get past here. Gadona is a desert country. It's very hot. Hello? Do we need papers this time? Common, the guide? You're going to Gadona? Go in the building all the way to get to the back to do your paperwork. All the way, I said. Oh. You don't need that. Immigration officer says, here you go. Hello, says Jurio. Hi. We're on the way back from our pilgrimage to Oldos. We're headed back to Folthia through the western route. Jurio showed the silver dagger. Oh. The silver dagger. Very well. Please go to the officer at the exit on the other side and show your silver dagger to him as well. Be sure to show your silver dagger to the officer at the exit on the side. Okay. I know it's that way. I just want to look around a little bit. Ruko says, we're going to Udor. I hear there are many forests in Udor. Woohoo! Forests normally excite you? Fowl says, Gadona's weather is pretty extreme, so I was thinking of moving to Udor, where there are forests and room to start a new life. My kids really like it there. I'm glad I am strong enough to leave Gadona. Chris says, Udor is a really nice place. Good luck with your new life. Oh, thanks. I'll do my best. I'm looking forward to my new life in Udor. Horace says, I was having lunch here. This courtyard is a nice place to rest. We're heading to Udor. I hope we can get there soon so we can enjoy the forests. I can't walk past you. That's interesting. Oh, wow. There's someone over there. I don't need that. Please, this way. Oh. I didn't mean to. I was trying to go around and talk to the other guy. Jurio says, we're on our way back to Falthia from our pilgrimage. Falthia? Chris says, has something happened in Falthia? Well, there's a rumor that King Rudolf of Falthia is trying to force Tirasweel to unify with him. Jurio says, that means he's trying to start a war? Yeah, says Chris. Anyway, it's only a rumor. Maybe it's completely untrue. You said you were on your way back from a pilgrimage, right? Let me see your silver dagger. Oh, here, says Jurio. Okay. Well, good job. You can go through. You might be worried because it's your home and all, but remember, it's only a rumor. Don't worry about it too much. Easier said than done. Good luck. You can go through. I want to go around and talk to anyone else who might be here. Oh. You'll be in the desert once you pass this border. There aren't any more towns once you get to Baraka, so make sure you're prepared. Barack Obama? We'll be checking that out. There's someone standing out here. Well, not him. This road is closed. Please go to the building and fill out all the necessary paperwork. We already did. It's illegal to enter through here. Illegal, I tell you. And who are you? Gulan the trader says, I am in the weapons business. Do you want to look at some stuff? Some stuff, huh? A sundering sword. That's what Jurio got. I couldn't remember the name. Crystal rod? For Chris, not an improvement. Sorcerer's staff. Look at that. Large shield. Jurio already has that. Bronze armor. We have better. We have fleeting robes, what we have, both of us. Alright, so I guess all we need is the sundering sword. Not sundering, no. The sorcerer's staff for Chris. Magically grown from a sapling, commonly in use among sorcerers. 3,800 piers. What that stands for. Thanks a lot! Okay, so Chris's attack, 96. Will now be 100. Magic attack, 115. Will now be 131. Awesome. Now, we do actually have more money than that. So, we can do the exchange. Exchange of 700 gores to peers. And ta-da, we actually have that much. And we can sell the other staff. Wherever it is in this long list. We have an extra fleeting robes in case someone else joins. Here, Staff of Light. We have two of them. Okay, we'll sell both. Yeah, I'm not sure if we always had an extra one. Or if Philly gave us her staff before she left. That'd be nice of her. Wait, we have an... All right! They do! They do give us their stuff when they leave the party. That's what's-her-name, Steel Bow. I forget her name. The Bard. The Bard Thief. Sherla. That's Sherla's bow. We'll hold on to it in case she rejoins us. You ready to talk to him? See if he has anything new to say. Looks like you have all your paperwork in order. You can head to Gadona anytime. Okay. What's in the middle here? Oh, this is... Oh, alright. These people... I thought they were over here, like, in this courtyard area. Wait, so who's this, then? I heard from a traveler who came from north of Gedona. He said that something strange is going on at Fothia's border. At the Fothia border? I heard that they have many soldiers standing guard near the border. But lately, I also heard that there are Fothia soldiers gathering at what appears to be a stronghold. Oh, paperwork? Go to that officer over there near the exit. We've already done that. There's also apparently a constant smell of gunpowder at the borders of Fothia. Okay. Alright, we are ready to move on then. Chris says, Jurio, we're almost to Gedona. So we're almost home. Kind of. Oh. Bellart's manipulation of Fenty was successfully thwarted by Jurio and his friends. They had heeded the Moonlight Witch's warning and faced the odds so that Gweld's prophecy would not be in vain. The incident in Fenty convinces the party even further that the prophecies aren't foretelling fates that cannot be avoided, but are messages left by Gweld. Ominous rumors abound of Fothia's intentions. What does Durzel, the man whom Great Oracle Dinkins suggested the party seek, know? What is about to happen in Fothia? I think we're about to find out. Jurio and Christina have little choice but to bear with their worries and cross the border from Fenty into Gedona. Ending Chapter 5, A Lake Divided, and beginning... Chapter 6, The Prophecy. Oops. Desert of Thirst. Well, that sounds interesting. Music. Okay. The East Desert checkpoint is 57 Milos. Wait, so that's 57 Milos? West is Baraka, 955 Milos. So this is 57 Milos. I like our footprints in the sand. That's pretty awesome. Alright, so let's do a save because I had a bunch of stuff happen. New song. Sounds good so far. There's a monster or monsters over here. Let's check out what they're all about. Jabberwoo and Shell's square ass? Is that what it says? That's what that is. Shell's square ass. Okay. Jurio will attack this thing. The Jabberwoo is completely unknown, so we'll have Chris do a finishing move on it. You figured ice would work well against these desert things. Let's see. It missed. Hopefully it finishes it off. It did. Sweet. Defense up. Not doing a lot of damage? Well, you didn't see how much your Jurio did. Oh, that's good. A lot of XP going on. Rinse and repeat. We'll just fight our respective square asses for now. It's an awfully weird and fun word to say. Square ass. Square ass. You damn square ass. Chris, level 26. We got shielding food and spicy food. Let's see if our bunny's hungry yet. Not hungry yet, okay. I'm missing our second healer. Philly needs to come back. Oops. Not you. Too bad we couldn't rest at the checkpoint. Look at that thing. Let's fight it. We're just short of that finishing move. Nice. They're raising their defenses. Doesn't matter, we'll kill you anyway. Closer to this one. Jurio might level up with the next battle. Saving over. Nice, another full mind potion. We'll fight you. It's torn between getting somewhere and getting XP. Finishing move, Orama. That's a lot of points, man. 76, wow. That's a lot more points. Come on, Jurio! Nice. Level 27. And spicy food. Still not hungry. I'm saying they should have something to give the rabbit to boost its metabolism so it'll eat more often. So we're going that way. No, this one. That one didn't have its defenses up. Well, she got her finishing move up already. They're replenishing a lot faster. I don't know if it's because there's two party members or they're higher level so they get the finishing moves faster, or it's just the enemies give finishing moves like they give experience, or some combination of the two. Further into the desert of thirst. There's a finishing move on each Jabba-woo. Missed. Ah, I didn't miss. One shot at him. Chris getting close to that next level. Getting almost 100 gores. Not gold. So funny because it's G and P. You would think gold and platinum, but it's gores and tears. Yeah, we're getting a lot of gores from these enemies. Alright, nothing up there. Oh, there's a lot of them. Well, wandering monsters. You know, this thing's gonna come over. I like that they're missing. Go Chris! Yes! Level 27. Wait. Not yet. Hungry! You guys must wait in stasis while we feed our pet. Got a lot of spicy food. Stamina food. Agility food. And vicious food. Alright, let's give it some aim... Angel. Spicy food uses fire-based attacks. Been a while. And you're in a normal mood? Normal mood. Yeah. Oh, you found something too late. Take this. I hardly did anything. Oh, it makes sense. Using fire against desert things. It's not gonna hurt him hardly at all. Oh well. Just thought of that. Realized it. And maul her? Oh wow. Nice. I just realized they have full meters now. Boom. Boomsty boom. So much XP is awesome. We'll fight you. Every time the pet finds something. Oh, we forgot to heal her. Damn it. Alright. Finishing move. Jabu A. Finishing move. Jabu B. Luckily, they're not even going for her yet. Very nice, we'll kill you now. She's not gonna be able to reach. Yeah. Missed, good. Alright, now we gotta heal her. What do you say? South is the desert checkpoint, 949 Milos, and north is Baraka, 63 Milos. Yeah, 50-ish, 60-ish Milos is like the little strip of land from the sign to the end of the screen. Chris says, so this is the town of Baraka. Against all odds, people live their lives in this town they built in the desert. Yo-Yo says, it seems to be a peaceful town. Why are they in a hurry? Someone just ran out. They stole something? Oh my god!